Leo is one of those unique union leaders who had an impact very early on in his career.
He had the ability to listen to what you had to say.
I remember so clearly when I first met Leo, this tall man who towered over me was also very kind and generous.
C'était un grand compteur, Léo. Léo, là, lorsqu'il compte quelque chose, vous pouvez entendre une mouche voler dans la salle. Qu'il y ait 500 000 ou 3 000 personnes, Léo pouvait retenir l'attention de tout le monde avec ses comptes.
I first got to know Leo as a fellow graduate of the Labor College of Canada. He was forceful, intelligent, and skillful. And I always listened when Leo spoke.
Leo and myself became very close in a long struggle for justice, for democracy, and to increase the benefits for all the working class, to protect and defend workers' rights. And we really became not only colleagues in solidarity or brothers, we became friends.
Once you get through the initial kind of boom of his voice and his position, and you dig down deeper on that, a wealth of knowledge will do anything for you so you can be successful to represent members or working people across the globe.
And he always was, in my view, a great leader. He was a great negotiator, a great human being, and he cared about the union, but what he cared about the most was the people.
He came up through the ranks. There's a big difference when you come up through the ranks. And you know, when you get to the top, you understand what has to be done.
He came roaring out of Local 6500 as a rank and file militant. And after he joined the District 6 staff, he showed that his militancy wasn't just a local phenomenon. He brought that to all of his work in the union.
Well, I've worked with a lot of energetic people in my life, but Leo Gerard was a whirlwind. He was endlessly spinning new ideas, clever plans, exciting strategies.
And just his knowledge, his depth of knowledge, breadth of knowledge on almost any subject. You can go toe-to-toe with anybody, and I really admire that.
I think of Leo's leadership in the political domain, where he worked years in and out of Canada and the U.S. and on the global stage to try to get the benefits that the steelworkers had got for their own members extended through political action to the community as a whole.
All the companies that we deal with, you look at Vale, you look at all the major steel companies, they're all foreign owned. You look at Glencore, you look at Rio Tinto. These aren't companies that just operate in Canada, they operate around the world. And what Leo had a vision in regards to building that solidarity around the globe, and that's why we have strategic alliances, be it in South Africa, be it in Australia, be it in Germany, be it in UK, which we then formed Workers Uniting, be it in Mexico, Brazil.
Having his voice be able to speak for not only U.S. workers, but Canadian workers, I think was a key to the NAFTA negotiations.
One of the things I know about Leo Gerard is that he never lost sight of his duty to continue organizing workers, to give workers the opportunities to have good family-supporting jobs, jobs that they could do with dignity.
Congratulations on two wonderful, wonderful careers as trade union leaders in Canada and United States.
It's been my great honor to be part of the global trade union movement with Leo and with Carol, two very special people, two very special trade unionists. I bring the solidarity, the greetings, and the messages of support from across the world. But most of all, I want to thank you for all that you've done to make us feel stronger within the movement and stronger in representing workers.
I know Leo and Carol and their commitment, their courage, and their idealism in pursuit of advancing the rights of working men and women who do so much to build our communities and our countries. So, Leo and Carol, there's only one thing left for me to say to you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Your work has strengthened our rights and our freedoms. It has improved the quality of life in our nations. And you did so against strong opposition frequently, but you succeeded.
His legacy at the steelworkers, at the USW, is built on that deep understanding and appreciation of the dignity of work. For that, I will be forever grateful. And for that, I, along with so many others, will always, always, always love Leo Girard. Leo, thanks, buddy.
Au board, Léo, j'ai apprécié aussi de travailler avec toi. C'était pas toujours facile, mais on a toujours réussi à s'entendre et à faire avancer les affaires pour nos membres. Donc, je te remercie pour tout ça, Léo, puis bonne retraite.
I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart and wish you all the best in your retirement.
And to Leo, I've already said nice things about you. All I'll say is have a terrific retirement. Enjoy yourself at your cottage. And please invite me and Janice to come up. I've become somewhat of a vegetarian now, so you'll have to learn a new way to cook.
Léo, je voudrais premièrement te souhaiter une bonne retraite à toi et ta famille. Et je voudrais aussi te remercier du fond du cœur pour tout le travail et toute l'énergie que tu as mis à bâtir notre syndicat. Tu es un homme de qualité et je te remercie, Léo. Passe une bonne vie et salutations.
Thank you very much, brothers and sisters. Thank you, Leo, forever. Our gratitude is forever. Thank you, Leo. Thank you, Carol. Thank you, all the members of the United Steelworkers, my brothers and sisters.